Senator, what's your reaction when Secretary Loizaga said, iminsan absent ang DENR sa hearing because there are so many events or duties, minsan walang representative daw ang DENR in those hearings?
Well, that is the duty of the regional executive director. It's not an easy job, definitely, but everything and anything that happens in that region is the responsibility, and to a certain extent, they have accountability for the implementation of laws. So the Region 7 executive director, the RED at that time, is responsible. And looking, moving forward, we must ensure that they know their duties. Meron bang mga tinatanggal na bundok dyan? So now it is temporarily closed. And that's just one protected area of the 94. I am certain that in each protected area, there could be violations. So we must look into that. But I will look into the IRR. But then again, we cannot just keep on giving reasons why laws are blatantly violated in this country, whether it's the ecological solid waste management, where people throw solid waste anywhere they wish, where even the Clean Air Act is violated, the Climate Change Act. Honestly, and I'll be very blunt here, in this country, a friend of mine who's an environmental lawyer told me one day when he was venting, he said, ang problema sa bansang ito eh, ang mga environmental laws, parang recommendation lang o suggestion eh, hindi pinapatupad. So really, I, as four-term senator, will exercise more strictly now the oversight function of Congress, of the Senate, in all environmental laws to ensure that all the policies that will protect us, 110 million Filipinos, will be implemented. Hindi madali. Okay.
Senator, easy, but do we need another agency that just focuses experts, but they just focus on protected areas, meaning it's a funded agency, they give the last approval, they study the areas, they take care of the areas, they monitor the areas, other than the DENR? The DENR, of course, is concerned with so many other things, right, Senator? You have mining, you have rivers, etc. But specifically for this law, do we need an agency?
We have the regional director under DENR. We have another bureau under the DENR, Biodiversity Management Bureau, that also takes care of protected areas. And we have so many people, many of them qualified, many of them with technical expertise and scientists and wisdom and knowledge and experience. It's difficult to explain. I'm not in their position, but I would like to call them to a room aside from an open hearing and really find out. I would like to call the mayor, the barangay captain, those who approved it then, and really try to understand the logic of their thinking. Why in their judgment that it was the right thing to do at the time. But if the DENR thinks it was right then why would they close it now? So they agree with us na mali. Because first of all, walang ECC eh.
But the problem nga ma'am, nagpapalit ang secretary ng DENR.
That's why there is a law. Regardless of who sits there, she or he must abide by the law. Regardless of who sits there as barangay captain or mayor or whoever is the NGO representative, must abide by the law. So perhaps a clearer understanding, and also how do you simplify, operationalize? Ito ang mahigpit na pinapagbawal. Ito lang ang pwedeng gawin. Ang protection,
doesn't seem to be clear. Like that captain speak, right? It's alienable and disposable. But even aesthetically and the size, that's not the kind of resort you would imagine in Chocolate Hills, right?
They must not just close it, but really just delete it.
Delete. Okay. deleted because of the size, the color. I mean, and the idea, it keeps expanding. You would think that they would be smaller, sustainable resorts.
Karen,
diba?
Sustainable use of areas in protected areas is allowed because yeah. there are strict protection zones and there are also multiple use. As I said, yeah. there are titled lands, there are those which are considered alienable disposable, and certain activities are allowed, except of course extractive activities. Bawal dyan ang quarrying, ang mining, bawal dyan ang mga fossil fuel na power plants, etc. However, pwede naman ang activities na sustainable, but not of that kind. I want to say words, but something's stopping me from saying the words I want to use.
Okay, all right.
I will tell you after the show.
No, just I'm going to go very quickly with some other areas that have been discovered. We can talk about this at another time at length. For example, yung Socorro Bayanihan Group, the alleged cult in Surigao del Norte, 2004. The Protected Area Community-Based Resource Management Agreement, itong PAC Brahma, that's the a legal instrument entered into by the DENR. So they gave it to those living there to conserve the land for 25 years, but then it became a whole town, right? So isa yun, ngayon binabawi ng DENR. And then Masungi is a whole other issue, but let's start first with ito, yung sa Surigao del Norte. The mayor knew about it, all the local officials knew that alleged cult grew. Then they started building more and more. Yun ang tanong ko, Senator. Areas.
Yes. Community-based and community-managed protected areas is important because we need to have the engagement of the local communities. The local communities can be indigenous peoples. The local communities can be the rural villagers. But, as I said, there are policies and rules on what activities can be done. There are policies and rules on what structures can be built. And I have not been to that area, and all I know is what transpired during the hearings. It seems like there was an abuse also of the agreement with the DENR. So there's a lot of marami pong dapat imbestigahan tungkol sa mga nakaraan para hindi na maulit ng muli ang mga agreements na pinapasukan ng DENR para po suriin natin din ang pagpapatupad ng mga grupo, mga NGO, people's organization, at mga pribadong sektor na pinapasukan ng agreement ng DENR.
Okay. So, ma'am, considering we've only talked partly about two, do you think the DENR, and I'm not talking about this DENR, not Secretary Loizaga's administration alone, but frankly speaking, in this country, is the DENR doing its job? Can it do its job, or it lacks the power, the manpower, the funding, expertise? Because why can't it do it better through the years?
I have a bill to empower an enforcement bureau of the DENR so that they will be able to implement our laws better. Yeah, it's a pending measure. In the meantime, that this is not enacted into law. In short, dapat meron silang puwersa para manghuli, para i-uphold yung ating batas. It's not yet a law. In the meantime, we have to make do with existing laws, and it cannot be said that there are no funds because we in Congress allow them to make the amendments. We support them in terms of the national budget. Of course, budgets are never enough, and we would say personnel are never enough. Mm-hmm. But then again, that's not a reason for the unabated exploitation of our natural resources, which is bringing our very own survival at risk. We cannot abuse nature the way we are doing it now. Parang walang batas eh. I feel that some people just look the other way. It's either complete ignorance or lack of understanding of the laws Or they look the other way, or corruption, or all of the above.
Okay. So on another note, I want to ask you about Masungi Geo Reserve. And I think the question on everyone's mind is, what is the future of Masungi Geo Reserve? So there's an issue. The DENR has said that the contract between Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation and their contract to conserve the area was void from the very beginning. That's what the DENR said. The DENR said there is no such thing as an endless contract, right?
In perpetuity.
So what's the future, Senator? You have this foundation that the civil society says is doing a good job, and yet they have a questionable contract. What happens now?
I would like to help them because I've not been there and I intend to go there soon. I wish you could join me to see the good work they're doing, because I've read it, I've seen it on video, and it could be a model for sustainable development for other activities within protected areas. The legalities have to be looked into. I was not privy to the internal processes at the time when the late Secretary Gina Lopez signed the agreement. There is an issue, I believe, on that agreement, and the Department of Justice has also given its own opinion on that 2017 agreement. So setting that aside, and that would be a legal issue between the proponents, and that is the Masungi Geo Reserve Foundation and the DNR and the DOJ's opinion. The opinion may be part of the MOA or the whole MOA. I still have to read it, although I've read portions of it. So setting aside the legal issue, the proponents or the foundation must also abide by laws, because it is part of the Upper Marikina protected area. That's part of the 2018 legislated protected areas, batas po yon. So the foundation managing should also, just like Captain Speak, follow and do repertorial functions, as all activities and proponents in protected area. However, what they're doing, if it's good, and from what I see, there are sustainable tourism activities that do not contravene with nature, which is aligned with nature, it could also be good models for other protected areas. So there are many discussions that need to be held. I would suggest that the proponents or the board of trustees or those managing the ecotourism activities and the protection and conservation of the more than 2,600, I believe, protected area Masungi Reserve, which is so important, have a serious legal discussion with the hierarchy, the secretary, the lawyers of the DNR, because it was inked, it was signed in a different administration, at the same time to include the Department of Justice. If there needs to be, just assuming that according to the Secretary of DNR, from what I heard during our hearing on Zoom, it was invalid ab initio from the beginning. Assuming that's correct, I still have to read the agreement. There should be a discussion, a meeting of the minds, so that they can continue under a new valid agreement, assuming the agreement was not valid. But it's not for me to decide that. I am speaking based on just what I heard during the hearing and things I've read, because I have to read all the documents that have been given me, and to also encourage all of them to talk to each other. Mag-usap, sayang naman i-baliwala, isa walang bahala ang magandang ginagawa. Alam natin ang ibang mga protected areas inaabuso. Alam natin hindi sustainable ang pag-develop ng mga ibang protected areas. Ito, maaring modelo at sa aking kaalaman, maganda at magaling at mukhang may puso ang mga namamahala dito. Kung merong bang legal infirmities yung pinasukan na agreement ay dapat mag-usap at isaayos. Pero dapat lahat may repertorial. Dapat may transparency sa management plan, sa mga activities, sa mga ginastos, sa mga kinikita. Dahil ito ay public land. Ang may-ari nito ay ang Filipino people, ang Republic of the Philippines.
Very good point, that end part where you said there has to be transparency with their cost and also the income, because it is owned by the Philippine government. Now, another pitch just quickly on Masungi is the possibility that there's a piece of land there that the BJMP wants to put up either the head office of a new prison site, kasi kulang na nga tayo ng space, right? For jails. What do you make of that?
I know that in a previous administration, a title was given to the Bureau, to the BUCOR, the Bureau of Corrections. Okay? So that's a legal document. That's a title. And if that information is accurate, then the BUCOR legally owns that. However, kung ako ang BUCOR, please naman po, huwag kayong magtayo dyan ng anumang gusali. Maaring pag-aari ninyo, ibalik na nyo sa Republic of the Philippines at gawin na lang yung conservation. Please lang. Hindi naman lahat ng napatituluhan ay tama. That was done during the president, to the time, I think, of President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. For what reason, I am not familiar. But I know there was a presidential declaration. So I understand that they are no longer planning to move there. I think it would be foolish for them to move there. Let the title remain if they own it. But remember, the BUCOR is government. That's still the Republic of the Philippines.
Yeah.
But please, huwag kayong maglagay ng kulungan dyan. Huwag kayong maglagay ng mga headquarters sa mga opisina dyan. Just leave it for conservation, please.
Actually, to close this, you make a good point that just because you own the land and you have a title to the land doesn't mean you can do what you want with the land.
In a protected area.
In a protected area.
Because there are laws. Yeah, there are very strict regulations and there are zoning for strict protection and for multiple use. Pag multiple use, mas maluwag. Kasi nga, as the title would say, multiple use pwedeng gamitin. Pero meron din pinagbabawal po sa multiple use. Hindi naman pwede yung nakakasira ng ating kalikasan. Babalik tayo sa titulo. Babalik tayo sa intent ng batas. Enhance biological diversity. Sa simpleng salita sa Filipino, para mapaganda ang ating kalikasan. Huwag payagan ang paglalabag ng tao para sa ating sariling kapakanan. Simple po eh, ang pagkalbo ng bundok, ang pagputol ng mga bundok, ang paninira ng lawa at ng ating karagatan, hindi po makakabuti sa tao, sa pagkain, sa kabuhayan. Kaya kailangan proteksyonan.
All right. Now, Senator, of course, there will be more hearings on this, so I do hope to have you back on the show. But very quickly, I know that the Venice Biennale, which goes on every year, that you initiated, you will be opening it this, I believe, April 18, 16 to 18, if I read it correctly. Tama ito. What can we expect just before we go with the Venice Biennale this year? And why is this important?
Yes, after 51 years, the Philippines was absent from the Olympics of Contemporary Art in Venice, Italy. So in 2015, we successfully brought it back at the time. And since then, we've been participating, the Philippines, in a pavilion. And this year, on April 18, will be the vernissage, or the opening of the Philippine Pavilion. Alternately, it is art and architecture. It is important because it shows the creativity of our curators, of the Filipino artists. It allows the Filipino to speak to the world and have conversations with different artists. It's nabuhay po ang ating contemporary art sector at nabibigyan ng halaga, nabibigyan ng boses, nabibigyan ng pagkakataon ang ating mga curators, hindi lamang yung mga kilala na at sikat na mga artists, even those who are up and coming. So we're happy to collaborate with the National Commission on Culture and the Arts and the Department of Foreign Affairs in supporting the Philippine participation in the Venice Biennale. But before we go, Karen, I hope you give me the opportunity to also greet our Filipino Muslims in the Philippines and abroad, all Muslims sa araw na ito po ng Eid al-Fitr. Ako'y nakikiisa po sa inyo, sa ating mga kapatid na Muslim, sa lahat ng panig ng ating mundo, na sana po'y patuloy ang ating kasaganahan at kapayapaan. Kaya isang araw ng pagpala at kapayapaan po sa ating mga kapatid na Muslim. Eid Mubarak.
On that note, I want to thank you for joining me this morning, Senator Lauren Legarda. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Karen. Maraming salamat.